The U.S. taxpayers have spent billions in the war in Afghanistan, but a new report now says that some of that money is falling into the wrong hands. Funds from a U.S. defense contract were allegedly funneled into the accounts of criminals and Taliban insurgents. David Ariosto is in Kabul, Afghanistan. David, thanks for joining us. Tell us, first of all, what was this money for? What was it supposed to do, and where did it go?
Suzanne, this represents the bulk of transportation costs here in Afghanistan. Effectively, we're talking about eight companies, four of which have been classified high risk. But these eight trucking companies were meant to deliver supplies, food, weapons to soldiers and civilians here across this country. Now, what has taken place, at least according to this internal document that CNN was able to speak with a source who provided details of that report. Effectively, what has transpired here is among these contractors, we've had a series of subcontractors. Now, keeping track of contracts and subcontracts, even in Washington, is difficult. In Afghanistan, it's even more so. So what we have here is a series of trucking contracts that have been subcontracted out to even smaller firms. Those firms might even look for even smaller entities. Trucking here in Afghanistan is dangerous. So
what
they will do, or at least according to this report, Sure. Effectively, what has happened is subcontractors have provided funds to security and some of these tribal groups in which they have direct links to Taliban insurgents. So effectively, what we're seeing here is, at least according to this report, is U.S. taxpayer dollars, at least in part, have filled and lined the pockets of the Taliban.
And who does the report blame for this?
Well, as is everything in Afghanistan, it's difficult to assign blame. Clearly, there's some transparency issues in terms of where this money went. The companies officials are pointing to in terms of their nefarious conduct. The overseers are being questioned in terms of their responsibility. But officials that we've spoken to have said they've radically revamped their program in an effort to stand up. Basically stamp out some of these bad practices.
All right, Suzanne? David, thank you very much. David out of Kabul, Afghanistan, appreciate it.